Threats to Navy vessels continue to grow in the form of drone swarms and anti-ship missiles. Now, after decades of experimentation, the Navy is closing in on a low-cost solution that can deter and defend against aerial threats at sea. The Navy received its first high-energy laser with integrated optical dazzler and surveillance, or Helios system, in the third quarter of fiscal from manufacturer Lockheed Martin, according to the company. The system, which can blast more than 60 kilowatts of directed energy at targets up to 5 miles away, is currently being installed on a Flight IIA Arleigh Burke-class destroyer that is undergoing upgrades, a company spokesperson told National Defense in an email. Helios enhances the overall combat system effectiveness of the ship to deter future threats and provide additional protection for sailors. And we understand we must provide scalable solutions customized to the Navy's priorities, said Rick Cordero, Vice President for Lockheed Martin Advanced Product Solutions, in a press release. Helios represents a solid foundation for incremental delivery of robust and powerful laser weapon system capabilities. Helios is part of the Navy Laser family of systems, a collection of platforms that the service envisions as the foundation of an incremental strategy for increased laser weapon capability, according to Navy budget documents. The weapon system addresses anti-surface warfare and counterintelligence, surveillance and reconnaissance gaps, with the ability to dazzle and destroy unmanned aerial systems and defeat fast inshore attack craft. The document stated, "The technology represents significant advances over current systems and options for countering UAV and anti-ship missiles. Surface-to-air missiles and Gatling guns require magazine depth on ships and have poor cost-exchange ratios when deployed against inexpensive drones," the Congressional Research Service. Plus, reloading Navy surface ship magazines requires the vessels to travel potentially hundreds of miles over a period of hours to get to a safe zone, said the report. Navy shipboard lasers, background and issues for Congress. The biggest concern right now in the emerging threats envelope is, how do you target, how do you track, and how do you disable potential swarms or saturation attacks by small unmanned vessels like micro UAVs, or even small surface vessels, since the Navy has concerns about that, said Tristan Sauer, land domain analyst at data analytics and consulting firm Global Data. As manned-unmanned teaming collaboration between a crewed platform and one or more drones becomes a more feasible technology, it is proliferating throughout the battlefield, even in countries with fewer resources, he noted. That's where laser weapon systems come in, because they have this extremely low cost per shot. There's this whole deep magazine, Sauer said. The fact that these weapons require so little energy just to deliver such significant effects, either lethal or non-lethal, this makes them just key and critical to ensuring sustainability of operations, particularly in the case of high-intensity conflict, Sauer said. The previous iteration of the solid-state laser quick reaction capability laser weapon system, or LAW, was a temporary installation on the USS Ponce. The system struggled to identify tiny targets, such as the smallest class of drones, he said. That's one of the problems Helios is meant to address. The system is designed for continuous operations using available ship power, instead of adding another energy magazine, according to Lockheed Martin. Similarly, the new system has advantages over past laser weapons in terms of power and positioning, a company spokesperson said. LAWs could only go up to 30 kilowatts of power and wasn't intended as a long-term installation, they noted. The Helios installation is taking place at the same time as an ongoing Aegis modernization effort in San Diego, California, the spokesperson said. The Aegis Weapon System, or AWS, is the Navy's command and control system that has been operational since the 1980s. Lockheed Martin also has a contract to modernize the system across destroyers and other vessels. Helios is a multi-mission laser weapon system, and all of its missions, including surveillance, will evolve over time as the Navy conducts at sea operations and develops tactics, training, and procedures for this new warfighting capability. Helios is being integrated into its vessel and the Aegis combat system, allowing permanent installation. The weapon uses spectral beam combined fiber lasers, giving it a higher beam quality than the incoherently combined six high-quality fiber lasers of Laws. The spokesperson said, "The Optical Dazzling Interdictor Navy, or ODIN, enables the system's dazzling technology by disrupting the electro-optical and infrared sensors on enemy platforms. It's a capability that exists on other vessels,